Dominus Cinephile.
Welcome to my movie and TV series reviews, where I will provide honest opinions of the latest releases. If the movie or TV series is a hit or a miss, be sure to know I will inform you. But if the movie or series is trash, be also sure to know that I will trash the hell out of the movie. I am Dominus Cinephile.
And the series on the review table today is the Hollywood comedy series The Gentlemen. The Gentlemen is an action comedy television series created by Guy Ritchie for Netflix, serving as a spin-off of Ritchie's 2019 film of the same title. The series features Theo James in the lead role and premiered on March 7, 2024. Joining Theo in the series are Kaya Scodelario, Daniel Ings, Joely Richardson, Vinnie Jones, Giancarlo Esposito, and Ray Winstone. The Gentleman follows the journey of Edward Horniman, who unexpectedly inherits a vast estate spanning 15,000 acres and the prestigious title of Duke of Halstead upon the reading of his deceased father's last will and testament. However, he discovers that the land has been transformed into a sprawling, weed-growing empire under the control of Susie Glass. Now, Edward must navigate a treacherous world filled with eccentric and dangerous individuals with sinister agendas, all while endeavoring to safeguard his home and ensure his own survival. As mentioned earlier, this series serves as a spin-off of Guy Ritchie's 2019 movie, The Gentlemen. Fans of the film were thrilled upon learning that Netflix was producing a series under the same title. While both the movie and the series are set in the same world, they are not directly connected. According to Guy Ritchie, the series is a journey into aristocrats encountering world gangsters. The setting remains the same. The aristocrats own magnificent houses and vast lands, but lack the funds for day-to-day living. The series delves into the transition, the evolution from a controlled environment to a chaotic one, and the strategies needed to survive in such a setting. If you enjoy my style of storytelling, you'll likely appreciate this one. Since its release on Netflix, the series has made it onto the Netflix Global Top 10 chart for TV. The Gentlemen Season 1 claimed the number one spot for the week of March 4th to March 10th, garnering 12.2 million views. Presently, the series continues to perform well, attracting more views beyond its initial numbers. Now let's delve into this review to see if the series lives up to expectations. First and foremost, the cast of this series was exceptionally outstanding and exciting to watch, especially with Giancarlo Esposito. There's no role on earth Giancarlo cannot play. He's a versatile actor. I admire when actors can transform into different characters effortlessly. Theo James delivered an outstanding performance as the lead actor, portraying Duke Eddie Horniman flawlessly. I couldn't help but think he would make a great James Bond in a James Bond movie. Daniel Ings is truly a remarkable actor, and his portrayal in this series is nothing short of amazing. His dedication to his craft is evident, and he delivers an exceptional performance. I remember him from the Netflix series The Crown in Season 1, where he also impressed in his supporting role. However, in this series he surpasses himself, delivering a performance that is entirely different from anything we've seen him do before. His commitment to the character Freddy is brilliantly executed. He captures the essence of this absurd, erratic, jealous brother flawlessly, portraying him as a coked-out, manic individual. From head to toe, his appearance exudes a sense of being completely strung out, adding depth to this absurd yet captivating character. His level of commitment to the role enhances an already outstanding show. Daniel Ings skillfully evokes both feelings of hatred and affection towards Freddy, making the character feel remarkably real. Kaya Scodelario shines as the formidable Susie Glass, embodying her character with captivating strength and authority. Her portrayal of a female leader is delightful to watch. There are no flaws in the performances of any cast member in this series. Kaya Scodelario and Theo James, who both starred in the Divergent trilogy, showcased excellent chemistry. In this series, their on-screen dynamic is equally impressive. Guy Ritchie certainly has a knack for selecting his cast for his films and series. The dialogue in this series was on par with the dialogue in the 2019 movie. Guy Ritchie is a master at crafting his movies, leaving nothing out of place. Well-crafted dialogue is an essential aspect of any story or script he works on. Ritchie has developed his own style of dialogue, where street thugs or gangsters communicate with a modern-day Shakespearean banter, elevating them above the vernacular of the average individual. Whether in a movie or a TV series, his dialogues are always entertaining. Nollywood filmmakers could benefit from learning how to craft dialogue from him. The storytelling style made a lot of sense, as each episode keeps you on the edge of your seat, trying to figure out the various scenarios, agendas, and schemes among the calculated characters throughout the show. On many occasions, you think you have it figured out, only to be proven wrong again with another brilliantly executed twist moments later. The plot races at breakneck speed, packed with twists and turns that will keep you guessing until the very end. While the action sequences are thrilling, it's the humor that elevates the show. Ritchie's signature wit shines through the sharp dialogue and hilarious situations. Most times I try to uncover errors or potential mistakes in the movies or series that I watch, acknowledging that there are no perfect films or TV shows. The Gentleman begins with a somewhat dragging, slow-paced style in the first episode, which might deter some viewers, especially if they are not familiar with Guy Ritchie's style of storytelling or filmmaking. However, the first episode gradually evolves into an enjoyable experience, leading into the subsequent episodes that make up for the initial sluggishness in the series. In summary, The Gentleman is a stylish action comedy with a healthy dose of British wit. The show boasts strong performances across the board, accompanied by a captivating story, memorable characters, and visually stunning presentation. From start to finish, viewers are kept on the edge of their seats as they navigate through each intriguing episode. While the complexity of the series might feel overwhelming for some, that's precisely the intention: to engage viewers with close attention and concentration, resulting in an overall entertaining experience. And now for my rating. The Gentleman scores an outstanding 8 out of 10. Thank you for watching. Please remember to like, comment, and share this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell icon for notifications. Also, be sure to follow me on TikTok, WhatsApp channel, and Instagram at Dominus Cinephile for more movie and TV series reviews. Dominus Cinephile, signing out.